愿大家平安。
May peace be to everyone.
我们下午讲的题目
，The title for this afternoon
是试炼中的喜乐
，is joy during trials.
我们请打开雅各书第一章
，That's under James chapter 1,
二到四节
，verses 2 to 4.
雅各书一章二到四节。
James chapter 1, verses 2 to 4. Verse 2, My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that a testing of your faith produces patience.
3, 第四节,
Verse 4, But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing.
这个雅各长老告诉弟兄们,
Here, Elder James tells the brethren,
你落在百般的试炼中,都要以为大喜乐。
They must count in all joy when you fall in various trials.
试炼本身是一件痛苦的事。
We know that trials itself is very difficult.
在痛苦的时候，人怎么会喜乐呢？
How can a person be joyful in times of trials?
这个就是相反的事情。
So this is very contradicting.
圣经里面常常有很多这种所谓的吊诡的事情。
Throughout the Bible, you can see many of these comparisons of contradictions.
那这种吊诡呢，有时候让人很难的理解。
And sometimes it's very difficult to understand these contradictions.
The paradox.
Paradox.
试炼很痛苦啊，会哭啊，怎么会喜乐呢？
When you're in trials and difficulties, you will cry. How can you experience joy?
属灵上啊，这是有可能的。
But it is possible spiritually.
不但只是有可能，还是要我们去追求的。
It's not only possible, but we must pursue it.
我们知道第一世纪的基督徒啊，跟我们生活的环境非常不一样。
We know that the first generation disciples are livelihood are different than ours.
我们今天担心的可能只是工作的压力。
And today we may worry about the pressures from work.
生病。
Maybe from health.
或者家庭啊有一些困扰。
Perhaps some crisis in the family.
没有基督徒啊，很少说为了信主会遇到逼迫或者是遇到很大的患难。
Very few percentage of Christians they say I am persecuted because I believe in Christ.
除非你生活在某一些极权的国家。
Perhaps if you fall under some kind of authoritarian country.
那我们一般人都很平安啊。
But most of us are very peaceful.
我们的试炼都是这种个人的困难。
And all of our thoughts are our personal problems.
但是第一世纪的基督徒，他们是面对大环境对他们的考验。
But the first generation disciples they encounter problems by the environment.
我们读希伯来书的时候也看过了。
When you have seen examples of this when you read the book of Hebrews.
当基督徒啊，守信仰是一件很危险的事情。
That to be an apostle and to maintain the faith is a very dangerous thing.
你可能会失去一切。
You may lose all.
甚至可能失去生命。
You may even lose your life.
这是雅各长老怎么勉励当时的信徒。
Then how did Elder James encourage the brethren at that time?
你们要看清试炼本身的意义在哪里。
You must look through the main purpose of a trial.
如果你不看清这个意义。
If you do not find this purpose.
你会觉得自己很倒霉。
You may feel like, oh, you are very unfortunate.
哇，为什么我遇到这种事
？How come I encounter such a thing？
是不是我不信可能更好啊
？It's better not to believe than to believe.
但是如果你看清楚试炼的意义
，But if you look through the meaning of the trial，
不单只你不会埋怨神
，Not only will you not grumble against God，
你还会感谢神
，Instead you will be thankful to our God。
因为你感谢神，你才会喜乐。
When you thank God， you will be joyful。
你就感谢神啊，我是配得过受试炼的。
You thank God that you are worthy to be counted to go through a various trials.
神不会随便试炼人。
God will not casually punish anyone.
你经得起试炼，神才试炼你。
Only if you are able to endure certain trial, God will give it to you.
像那些工匠，那些很厉害的师傅。
Just like those an architect, those very nice
打铁那种 blacksmith 啊。
And sometimes a blacksmith.
他们拿一块铁。
They may take a metal.
哎呀，这块铁，看那个样子，没有用了。
If you look at the surface, it seems it's very useless.
因为他们很会看，知道这一块是什么东西。
And they have a keen eye. They know what this material is used for.
这一块一打就破的了，或者根本省的，哎呀，不要打了。
They say this piece is a waste of time. Once I start working, it will break.
他就会丢到外面那个废铁堆当中。
And he will toss this piece into a wasteful basket.
哎，这一块是可造之材。
And they say, oh, this piece is a good material.
好，他就开始去烧它。
Then it will be go through a process of burning.
哇，把它烧得红红的。
And it will burn to a degree, it will turn red.
软软的。
And it will become softer.
啊，这个时候就开始敲了，很大力的敲了。
And after that process, it will use force to hammer it.
好，那再把它冷却。
Then it will cool it.
哎，再把它烧。
And then to burn it again.
哇，要打了。
And then to hammer it again.
啊，到最后它就变成一个工匠所要的宝贵的器皿。
Later on, eventually become a useful vessel for the craftsman.
可能是一把宝刀啊，宝刀就是这样打出来的。
Perhaps it is a unique sword.
如果那个他不要打的，这个直接丢了。
And if they don't want to start the work, it will be tossed away.
所以看起来啊，雅各长老知道试炼本身的意义在哪里。
So you can see that Elder James knows the purpose of a trial.
如果神愿意你接受试炼。
And if God wants to give you a trial.
第一就是觉得你有希望。
And first, God knows that there is hope.
觉得你可造之材。
And knows that you are able to be molded.
第二，神知道你承担得起。
And secondly, God knows that you can handle it.
第三，神知道你被试炼之后你会完全不一样。
And thirdly, God knows that after trial, you'll be completely different.
好，那我们今天来讲讲啊，苦难当中啊，试炼当中怎么可能会喜乐？
So now we're talking about in times of trial, how can we be joyful?
这时候我们要了解试炼的三个目标的目的在哪里。
We must realize the three main purpose of a trial.
原来啊，苦难试炼是让我们荣神益人最好的方法。荣神就是荣耀神。
So the one of the first purpose of a trial is to glorify God.
我们基督徒啊，一辈子都记得这四个字。
As a Christian, you must remember these four words.
我们不是追求发达、出名、长寿，不是。
We do not pursue wealth, fame, or advanced age.
我们基督徒就是追求这四个字。
As a Christian, we must pursue these four words.
荣神益人。
They meant to glorify God.
还有呢，对人有益处。
And that will benefit to all men.
我们下午分享三点。
So this afternoon, we'll talk about these three points.
第一，苦难会让我们荣耀神。
During trial, we'll be able to glorify God.
第二，苦难会让我们得到的造就。
And secondly, when we go through trials, we will be edified.
第三呢，苦难会让我们可以去安慰别人。
Then thirdly, when we go through trial, we can comfort others.
啊，这个就是对神、对自己、对别人都有益处。
And this is beneficial to God, to men, and to ourselves.
好，我们来讲第一点。
So let's talk about first point.
受试炼、受苦难，为了让我们得尊贵荣耀为冠冕。That
when we are under suffering, we will receive a crown, right?
我们看希伯来书第二章。That's
from Hebrews chapter 2.
希伯来二章的第九节。Hebrews
chapter 2, verse 9. Verse 9, but we see Jesus, who was made a little lower than the angels, but for the suffering of death, crowned with glory and honor, that he, by the grace of God, might taste death for everyone.
这里说主耶稣来到世上的时候，比天使还小一点点。
Here it says, Jesus Christ was made little lower than the earth, than the angels, but he was on earth. What does that mean?
主耶稣带着肉体,
Jesus is with flesh.
他有肉体的软弱,
he has the flesh, the weakness of the flesh.
会肚子饿,
he'll get tired, he'll be hungry.
还有呢,
additionally, he is bound by time and space.
至少他不能飞啊,
and he was limited that he cannot fly like the angels.
天使不用肚子饿,
the angels will not be hungry, but Jesus will.
还有主耶稣成为人的样子,
and Jesus took the form of a man.
哎呀，看起来好像真的是比天使还不如啊。
On the surface, it seems like he is not even worthy of an angel.
但是主耶稣基督怎么样从卑微的人、卑微的罪人又得到荣耀冠冕呢？
How can Jesus Christ, even though being lowly and pitiful, become receive glory and honor?
你要降卑很容易啊。
To become lowly is very easy.
但是怎么再爬上去？
Then how do you get back up there?
这里说的是透过受死的苦。
And here it says this, he received the suffering of death.
他为我们尝了死味。
That for us he tasted death.
我们知道食物都有味道啊，鲜酸甜苦的。
We know that food has different kind of taste, spicy, salty, sweet, and sour.
你自己吃过才知道这个味道。
Well, only after you have tasted, you will know what flavor it is.
没有人可以跟你形容啊。
No one can describe it to you.
那他死也是一样。
And death is also the same thing.
我们在座的人，在听道理，现在我们都还没有尝过死，还没有死过。
All of us who are listening to sermons right now, we have not tasted death.
我们心还在跳，我们还活着的。
Our heart is still beating, we are still alive.
所以我们还没有体会到死的那个味道是什么。
So we do not know what the taste of death is.
当然啊，有一天我们都要死。
But naturally, one day we will die.
但是大部分的我们可能是病死。
And maybe some of us will die of illness.
这个是 不好受，但是也不没有说十字架那么痛苦啊。
And this is not easy to go through, but it's not comparison to the suffering of the cross.
十字架是人类历史以来其中一个最残忍的刑罚。
Crucifixion is in the history of mankind is one of the cruelest execution.
好好的一个人把他钉在木头上面。
That you nail a perfectly fine person onto a wood.
那身体呢没有办法有支撑着。
So and his body's weight is unable to support himself.
手脚都很痛，因为被钉着。
And your hands and feet are pierced by nails.
那每一次呼吸都很困难。
And it's very difficult to breathe.
他还要在上面啊，有一些人呢，好几天甚至一个礼拜都死不去。
And some examples of people hanging on the cross for a week or several weeks.
所以这个死的味道啊, 很恐怖。
So you can see the terribleness of the taste of death.
所以说没有必要来为我们尝这个死味。
Jesus Christ didn't need to taste death for us.
但是他选择要为我们尝死味。
But he chose to taste death for us.
这是为了我们的罪的缘故啊。
And for the reason is for our sake of our sins.
为了要救我们的灵魂。
He wants to save our souls.
所以主耶稣曾经讲过。
So therefore Jesus once said,
约翰12章23到24节。
John chapter 12 verse 23-24.
约翰福音12章23到24节。
Gospel of John chapter 12 verse 23-24. But Jesus answered and said to them, "The hour has come that the Son of Man should be glorified. Most assuredly I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains alone, but if it dies, it produces much grain."
23节, 主耶稣说人子得荣耀的时候到。
On verse 23, Jesus Christ said, "The hour had come for the Son of Man."
如果今天你看到这句话，可能以为，哎，这个人去选总统了，啊，当选了。
And today, if you read this verse, you say, "Oh, this person is going to become a president."
你当了加拿大的总理，你就有荣耀啊。And
you will receive glory when you become the leader of Canada.
或者是你要做大事，你得荣耀了。Or
for example, you want to do something, something great, you may receive glory.
但是主耶稣讲这句话也是很吊诡。
So you see a paradox of Jesus Christ saying this phrase. He said the Son of Man should be glorified.
怎么得荣耀?
How is it going to be glorified?
他要像一粒麦子掉到地里死了。And
just like a grain of rice falling to the ground and dies.
我们知道一颗麦子啊，它从那个麦穗上面掉到地下，就是代表它谦卑自己。
So you can see a symbolic representation of a grain falling out of wheat, it is humbling itself.
还有呢,这个麦子要变成种子,要被打破。
And this rice, this grain shall be falling to the ground, it should be broken.
自己没有了。And
it will die.
就变成很多籽粒来。And
it will produce much grain.
原来这个就是荣耀神。And
this will bring glory to God.
一个人的受苦带来全人类的救恩。One
person's suffering brings the salvation to mankind.
一个人的羞辱带来神的荣耀。
One person's humiliation brings the glory of God.
一个人的刑罚带来全人类的平安。One
person's execution brings the peace for all mankind.
这个叫得荣耀。And
this is to receive glory.
原来属灵的荣耀不是自己争取的。Special
glory, you cannot attain it yourself.
也不是你选票，你选你要当什么，多少人支持你的荣耀。
It's not an election where you get different votes to get certain kind of glory.
也不是按职事升长老，或者是当总负责那种荣耀。
And it's not based on elders, deacons, or positions at any place. So the glory, the true glory itself, you must sacrifice yourself. To sacrifice oneself, it must go through a trial. When the apostles first began the apostleship, they were very happy.
哇,耶稣选我们啊,
Jesus chose us to be his disciples.
多威风啊,耶稣走在前面,
It's very honor to follow after Jesus Christ. He's walked before us, we follow.
耶稣变饼的时候，很多人跟着，我们跟着耶稣也很威风。And
when Jesus Christ broke bread, we follow him. We also feel very glorified.
耶稣叫死人复活。Jesus
Christ resurrected the dead.
哇，大家在拍手。Everyone
claps their hands.
我们当门徒也很风光啊。That
we, as the disciples, we also receive some kind of glory.
但是这个不是真正的神的荣耀。But
this is not truly God's glory.
真正的荣耀是你被考验了。
So true glory is when you are being tested.
你当使徒了，你当门徒了，你被逼迫了。
You become an apostle or disciples, and you are persecuted.
你要被追杀了。And
someone's coming to kill you.
好，你跑到别的地方，你还在传福音。And
you flee to a different place, and at that place you preach the gospel.
他们就抱步的主耶稣基督的后尘。
And they carry on the will and descendants of Jesus Christ.
Footstep, follow Jesus' footsteps.
They follow the Jesus Christ footsteps.
十二个门徒里面，除了约翰之外，大部分都是殉道者，都是被杀死的。So
all the from the 12 disciples, most of them are except for John, they were all killed.
因为约翰神要他活得久一点，要在那个海岛上面写启示录。
And John lived a long age, and he wrote the book of Revelation on the island.
其他十一个全部都被杀死了，都是殉道者。
And other disciples were evangelists, they were all killed.
哇,但是因为他们也像耶稣一样,一粒麦子落在地里。
And because they are just like Jesus Christ, a single grain fall into the ground.
他们也荣耀神。And
they glorify God.
今天弟兄姐妹,我们没有那么伟大,我们还没有到为耶稣死的这个地步。
And brothers and brethren, we may not be as great as them to the point that we may die for Jesus Christ.
但是也许在信仰上面啊,你被熬炼了。
But during in your faith, you may be tested.
这个时候你就要想想。
At that time, you must reflect.
主要我经过这个苦难。
And Jesus Christ wants me to go through this trial.
到底是为了什么目的？
And what purpose is behind these trials?
如果是为了让我能够荣耀他。
If it's the purpose for me to glorify God,
我就求主耶稣继续的帮助我们。
Then I ask God to continue to help me.
能经过这个考验，不要放弃。
To help me maintain me throughout this trial.
我们看哥林多后书四章十六节。
That's in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16.
哥林多后书四章十六节。
2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16. Therefore, we do not lose heart, even though our outward man is perishing, yet the inward man is being renewed day by day. 17. For our light affliction, which but for a moment is working for us as far exceeding an eternal weight of glory. 18. While we do not look at the things which are seen, but at things which is not seen, for the things which we are seen are temporary, and the things we are not seen are eternal.
这里保罗他自己也有这种体会。
So Paul has his own personal experience.
但是我们啊的身体啊越来越毁坏。
So our man is perishing.
我们今天如果身体毁坏，可能是老了或者生病了。
And today's term means that we may get older, we may have certain kind of illness.
但是保罗还有他们当时的使徒们啊，其实不是那么老，也没有生什么绝症。
So Paul and his apostles at that time, they were not experiencing old age or some kind of illness.
但是他们身体越来越差了。
But their body is perishing.
为什么？
How come?
因为传福音太辛苦了。
Because it's very hard to preach the gospel.
吃又没得好吃。
And they don't have a good meal to eat.
睡也没得好睡。
They wouldn't have a good place to sleep.
常常逃命，被打，被逼迫，下监牢。
And oftentimes they have to flee from one city to another city, and they be put into prison and be beaten.
但保罗被打很多次。
And Paul was beaten many times.
身体可能很多旧伤。
And throughout his body, you may have seen the old bruise.
营养又不够。
And he is maybe malnutrition.
又没有一个家庭可以照顾他，常常都自己一个人。
And there is not a family who can take care of him. He is always by himself.
所以真的是一个很大的考验。
You can see it's such a great trial that he's going through.
如果他每天看镜子啊，一定看到一个自己都认不出来的自己。
Now, if he were to look at a mirror every single day, he may not recognize himself.
但是他不上当。他不上当。
But he do not lose heart.
但是他觉得说，我想起将来给我的极终无比荣耀的荣耀。
He said that he is waiting for the eternal glory that's waiting for him.
这个就是神的荣耀了。
And this is God's glory.
所以我虽然暂时受苦，我还是要荣耀神。
Even though I am suffering right now, but I must glorify God.
弟兄姐妹，我们要立志，就算在受苦当中，我们也要荣耀神。
Brethren, we must make a determination. Even though we are suffering, we must glorify God.
有一个弟兄，他被告知他得了不治之症，绝症。Terminal illness.
This brother who was diagnosed with terminal illness.
啊，他一开始也是很伤心。
Initially, he was very sad.
但是后来想过来。
But later on, he came to realization.
他说啊，虽然主让我生这个病。
That since Christ, Lord wants me to have this kind of illness.
但是我立志，我的生病我要荣耀神。
That even though I am ill, I will glorify God.
我们以为啊，生病好了才能够荣耀神。
We think that, oh, only when we are healed, we will glorify God.
这是个错误的观念。
This is a misconception.
圣经说，生也荣耀神，死也荣耀神。
Bible says, when you are alive, glorify God. When you are dead, also glorify God.
如果主耶稣让我好，当然荣耀神。
If Jesus Christ want me to become better, I will glorify God.
但是如果主耶稣让我就是这样子走了，我也要荣耀神。
But if Jesus Christ let me pass on with this illness, I will also glorify God.
他决定他用积极的心态去面对。
But he wants to face this with his own mentality.
弟兄姐妹来看他。
And brethren went to visit him.
都没有安慰他。
And they didn't encourage him.
反而他安慰弟兄姐妹。
Instead, he was encouraging the brethren who visited him.
要有信心，我们不要放弃他。
To have faith, do not give up on God.
哇，好像他后来勉励那些去看他的人。
And he encouraged those who went to visit him.
还有的他在身边呢，那些同房的病人啊、护士啊，他都跟他们讲话、传福音。
And he was preaching to co-patients and nurses passing by.
他这样好像一个很喜乐的人。
So he was a very joyful person.
看不出来是一个绝症的人。
You cannot tell that he was a terminal ill patient.
在医院里面也传福音，成功带领人来信主。
And he was very successful at his preaching in the hospital. That he brought one person to believe.
所以这个就是荣耀神啊。
And this is bringing glory to God.
虽然他最后也是离开世界。
But and even though later on he left this world.
但是他用他的死、他的生活、他的生命来荣耀神。
But he used his life, his death to glorify God.
就今天我们有没有把自己放在神的荣耀里面？
So today, have we put ourselves in the glory of God?
受苦是为了让我们可以荣耀神。
Suffering is for the sake of bringing glory to God.
当然了，这个要有一个条件，你受苦不是因为你的犯罪。
But there must be a condition that when you are suffering, it's not because of your sin.
如果你认为你犯罪而受苦, 你就不能荣耀神了。
That if you are suffering because you have sinned, then you will not bring glory to God.
好, 那我们来讲第二点。
Now let's talk about the second point.
受苦, 让我们可以得以完全。
When we go to suffering, it will make us complete.
我们看希伯来书二章十节。
Hebrews chapter 2, verse 10.
希伯来书二章十节。
Hebrews chapter 2, verse 10. Verse 10, for it's fitting for him for whom on all things and whom on all things in bringing many sons to glory to make captains of the salvation perfect throughout suffering.
这里说呢, 主耶稣基督因为受苦难,
here it says that Jesus Christ became complete when he go through suffering.
有人就说了,
then some people say, oh, then are you saying Jesus Christ is not perfect?
难道主耶稣还没有钉十字架之前就不完全吗?
Are you saying that before Jesus Christ was crucified, he was not perfect?
当然主耶稣都是完全的。
Naturally, Jesus Christ is all perfect.
主耶稣是神成为人来到世上，他当然是完全人。
Jesus Christ is God becoming flesh into this world. Of course, he is perfect.
但是这里说因为苦难才得到完全。
But here it says, only through suffering he may achieve perfection.
不是因为说他不受苦就在神面前不完全的意思。
It's not to say that, oh, if he does not go through suffering, he is not perfect.
不是因为犯罪的不完全。
It's not because he sinned and he is not perfect.
而是说他透过受苦啊，完完全全的才有办法了解人的生活，人的苦难。
It's only when you go through suffering when you can completely, fully understand the pains of man.
主耶稣才有办法完全理解我们呢，才能够办法完全帮助我们啊。
Then only when Jesus Christ understands us completely, then he can help us.
我们看第四章，希伯来四章的十五节。
That's in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 15.
四章十五、十六节。
Chapter 4, verse 15, 16, 15. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all point tempted as we are, yet without sin. 16. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need.
这一节就是我们最近一直在读的。
So this verse we are reading this week.
我们觉得这一节很宝贵。
We are these verses are very precious.
最宝贵是哪一个字？
Which word is the most precious?
我个人觉得呢，最宝贵就是体恤这个字。
Personally, I think that the word sympathize is the most important.
什么叫体恤？
What does it mean to sympathize?
我经历过你这个苦，所以我可以理解你。
I have gone through what you've gone through, so I understand.
这个叫体恤啊。
And this is mean to sympathize.
如果你从来没有牙痛过,
if you never have teeth ache before,
别人牙痛很辛苦，我在哭啊，你在哭什么？牙齿一颗而已啊，小小的，有什么好哭的？ It's about 痛的。
Then when someone is crying because I had a toothache, you will make fun of them. It's only a small teeth. Why are you crying?
哎，你不知道啊，牙痛产过大病，牙痛影响整个头，变头痛，整个人会很不舒服。
But you do not know that when you have toothache, it connects to part of your brain, so you'll be in great pain.
你牙齿很好啊，从来没有痛过，所以没有办法体会啊。
So your teeth is great in condition. You may not have experienced toothache before.
人很多痛苦，因为被罪迷惑，生老病死。
And men, because men's suffering because we grow old, we sin.
人很多的眼泪.
Men have shed many tears.
神在天上说：“哎呀，你们很可怜。”但是他自己没有体会过.
And God in heaven, He may say that, "Oh, you guys are pitiful, but He has not experienced what we've gone through."
就好像你看到非洲的小孩没得吃、没衣服穿，我那边有蝗虫。你看那个新闻，一点感觉都没有.
Sometimes you see that children in Africa, they don't have clothes to wear or foods to eat, and there was yellow fever going on.
你吃你的大汉堡，吃你的炒饭、炒面，然后一直看那个新闻，一点感觉都没有。
And you may eat your burger or fried rice, and you will not have any sympathy.
不好吃，你又说这个咬一口就不要了。
And sometimes you may bite into something, and you throw it away because it tastes bad.
因为没有体会过饿了三天三夜那种感觉。
But you haven't experienced what does it mean to be hungry for 3 days and 3 nights.
神在天上。 本来他在天上看你们，哎呀，人很可怜哦，挺可怜的。
So Jesus, God in heaven, He may say, "Oh, you guys are very pitiful."
谁叫你们犯罪？
So who led you to sin?
又不听话。
You are very disobedient.
神没有办法完全理解，因为他那个时候没有肉体。
So God at that time could not completely understand because He did not have a flesh.
啊，直到他成为人的形象来到世上。
Until He became flesh into this world.
哎呀，那做人那么辛苦的。
They realize it's very difficult to be a man.
当穷人那么辛苦的,
it's very difficult to be a poor man.
被人家弃绝那么辛苦的,
it's very hard feeling when you get rejected.
他看到别人死了孩子, 所以说还会哭耶。
Jesus Christ even shed tears when he saw that other people's children were died.
到最后被钉在十字架上面。
And finally, he was nailed onto the cross.
钉十字架前又很恐惧。
And before he was on the cross, he had a sense of fear.
哇，又被最爱的人出卖。
And he was also betrayed by the one he loved the most.
这个他经历过的，就能够体恤人的软弱。
He has gone through everything that man should go through, so he can empathize with us.
如果没有受苦，这方面就不完全。
If he did not go through this kind of suffering, he in this aspect he would be imperfect.
有一个传道，有一次他开刀啊。
And there was a pastor one time, he was going through an operation.
生病完，开完刀，哇，出来很辛苦。
After post-surgery is very hard on the body.
哇，那这个时候传道娘在旁边照顾他。
Then the preacher's wife at that time was taking care of him.
哇，那么传道娘哀哀叫说，哇，好辛苦啊，好辛苦啊。
Then the preacher at that time, he was wailing, saying he's going through some kind of pain.
哇，那个传道娘就说。Then
the preacher's wife said,
啊，你不是以前常常去访问人吗，勉励人吗？
That didn't you go often to visit people and encourage people before?
那你现在用你去勉励别人的话来勉励你自己就好了，就会舒服一点了。Now
use those same words you encourage all the people to encourage yourself, then you will feel better.
哦，这个传道他还传说，哎呀，不一样啊，不一样。Then
the pastor say, oh, it's not the same.
以前我教完教我信心啊，喜乐啊，都很容易。And
he said previously, I have faith and I have joy. It's very easy to comfort others.
要交托啊，都很容易讲。
And the words of entrustment is very easy.
现在自己受苦，觉得真的是不一样啊。But
now that I am suffering myself, it is very different.
从那个时候开始，他好了之后去访问病人，那种感觉，那种态度就不一样。And
soon after he recovered, then when he went to visit other patients, then the attitude is completely different.
因为他受过苦啊，他能够体恤别人。Because
he has gone through suffering, he is able to sympathize with others.
人被体恤，那种感觉是很敏感的。
So when you are sympathizing with other people, this feeling is very sensitive.
如果这个人可以理解你，你马上就跟他连接。If
other people feel that you can understand him, you will have a connection.
你跟他连接之后，你讲他的什么话，他会听你，因为你也受过这个苦。But
when you have established a connection, they will listen to what you have to say because you have gone through what they are suffering.
原来苦难呢，是要主耶稣跟我们连接。So
the suffering itself of Jesus Christ is so that he can connect with us.
我们看以赛亚书63章第9节。
Isaiah chapter 63, verse 9.
以赛亚书63章第9节。
Isaiah chapter 63, verse 9. Verse 9, in all their affliction he was afflicted, and the angel of his presence saved them. In his love and in his pity he redeemed them, and he bore them and carried them all the days of old.
这里说啊，在一切的百姓的苦难当中啊，神呢也是跟我们同受苦难。
He says, in all their affliction he was afflicted with us.
这什么意思？
What does that mean?
神为什么要受苦？
Why did God need to suffer?
因为他要跟我们连接。
Because he wants to be connected with us.
一连接了，就能够救我们，就能够怜悯我们，救赎我们了。
Only when we are connected, he is able to save us and give us salvation.
所以主耶稣一定要来钉十字架的。So
Jesus Christ needs to come and be crucified on the cross.
一定要当穷人，一定要被钉被害。He
needs to become a poor person. He needs to be suffered the pain of dying on the cross.
没有这个部分就不完全。
If without this process, he is imperfect.
救恩就不能成全。Then
salvation will not be complete.
所以我们今天不用害怕。So
today we should not fear.
主耶稣也经历过那么多苦难的。Jesus
Christ also went through many sufferings.
他完全可以理解你的感受。He
will completely understand your feelings.
你走不下去的时候。That
when you think you cannot go on any longer.
你疲累的时候。When
you are tired.
你怀疑的时候。
When you have doubts,
就说你想抱怨的时候,
even when you are about to grumble against God,
主耶稣完全理解,
God, Jesus Christ completely understands you.
因为主耶稣跟你连接,
because Jesus Christ has connected with you.
苦难也会让我们跟神连接,
that trial itself will bring us closer to God, make a connection.
刚刚讲的是主耶稣首先他主动跟我们连接嘛,
so we have talked about Jesus Christ taking initiative to make a connection with us.
好了，今天我们为什么要受苦呢?
So today, why do we suffer?
如果你生活很平顺哦, 你对信仰不会有什么体验。
That if your life is very smoothly, you will not have many experiences in faith.
当然了，如果我们有的选的话，我们不希望生活有任何的痛苦。But
if we were to choose, we would choose our life to be peaceful and without sufferings.
就好像你看你的孩子。Just
like when you look at your children.
你都不希望你的孩子受苦啊。You
do not wish your children to suffer anything.
但是如果你孩子从小到大没有受过一点苦的话，会怎么样？But
what if your children never suffer anything from youth?
他永远不会长大。And
that your child will never grow up.
他会变得很自私。
He will become very selfish.
他不会感恩.
You will not be thankful.
所以有时候受苦是让他长大的一个非常重要的环节.
So suffering it is pivotal for a person's growth.
所以我们如果没有接受这些苦难,
So if we have not gone through these sufferings,
我们也不会完全的。
We will not be perfect.
我们的不完全有很多的方面。
There are many areas of our imperfections.
但是如果我们受苦的时候一想起主耶稣,
But when we are going through suffering and we think about Jesus Christ,
我们又跟主耶稣连上了。
And we connect ourselves with Jesus Christ.
这苦难真的太奇妙，试炼真的太奇妙。
So you can see how miraculous it is that when we go through trials,
直接把我们跟神连上。
Is to directly connect ourselves with God.
有一个弟兄他在家里啊，做一些工程。
And there was a brother, he was doing some work at home.
哇，不小心了，那个工具切到手。
And one time accidentally he hit a tool on his hand.
流很多血。
And he bled a lot.
马上去医院。
And immediately he went to the hospital.
缝很多的针。
And he received many stitches.
还有后来又有发炎了，非常的弄了很久。
And later on it was infected and it took a long time to heal.
有一次，他医院的时候，他太太去看他。
And there was one time, me and my wife went to visit him in the hospital.
他的太太一看到他，哇，这个弟兄就哭起来。
And when his wife saw him, his brother started to cry.
哇，太太就问他，你哭什么？
And his wife said to him, "Why are you crying?"
是不是很痛？
Is it painful?
他说啊，痛死了。
And said, "It is very much painful."
但是他说，我哭不是因为我自己的痛。
He said, "I cry not because of my own pain."
太太问他，那你哭什么？
Then his wife asked him, "Why are you crying then?"
哇，他说，我是想起主耶稣。
And he said, "Oh, I am thinking about Jesus Christ."
我切到是身体一个部分而已。
I only cut one part of my body.
主耶稣是全身被鞭打被钉。
But Jesus Christ, he was beaten throughout his entire body.
还有呢，我又吃麻醉药。
And also, I also took some morphine.
痛的时候可以减轻。
And when it is painful, I take a painkiller and reduce the pain.
主耶稣什么麻药没得吃。
But Jesus Christ did not have any painkillers.
主耶稣比我更痛。
And Jesus Christ suffered more than I did.
主耶稣为了我的罪承受这些痛。
And for my sins, Jesus Christ suffered these kind of physical pains.
每一次在痛的时候想起主耶稣，我就流眼泪。
Every single time when I am in physical pain, I think of Jesus Christ, I will shed tears.
这个本来是一个试炼。And
this itself is a trial.
但是这个苦呢，这个试炼呢，又跟它跟主耶稣连上。
But this trial is directly connected with Jesus Christ.
如果苦难让你跟主耶稣连上，你受的苦就有点意义。
That if you're going through some trials and it connects your with God, then it is with some purpose.
好，我们再来看约伯记的23章的第10节。Let's
look at Job chapter 23, verse 10.
约伯记23章第10节。
Job chapter 23, verse 10. But he knows the way that I take. When he has tested me, I have come forth as gold.
这里约伯他被试炼的时候，讲述了这句话。
This is what Job said when he's going through trial.
他虽然不知道他犯了什么罪也好，或者是什么原因，属灵上面为什么他会被试炼的那么惨？
He doesn't have any idea about why he's going through suffering, either through spiritually or anything.
一天之内失去所有的家产。
And one day he lost everything.
失去所有的儿女。
He lost all his children.
全身呢长疮。
And throughout his body, he starts to have pores.
说实话，他想来想去啊，不知道他到底做了什么错事。
Therefore, he starts to reflect. He doesn't know what wrong he has committed.
有时候，真的你思前想后啊，想不到什么原因，为什么我一定要经历这样的事。
Sometimes you may think for a long time, why are you going through suffering, and you can't think of a reason.
我们读经的人才知道，原来灵界里面有事情在发生。
Only if you read the scripture, you will know that there are things that are happening in the spiritual realm.
那魔鬼啊控告那个约伯。So
you can see that the Satan, he accuses Job.
神说，我容许你试炼他，但是你不可以拿他的生命。And
God said to Satan, "I allow you to tempt Job, but you shall not take away his life."
神有主权呢，神有决定权做任何的事情。God
has autonomy, authority to do anything.
不是因为约伯犯了什么罪。
It's not because Job has committed any sins.
这个人啊，不能用自己的理性去解释这些属灵的事情。Man
cannot use his own logic to describe the spiritual realm.
那约伯不明白。So
Job did not understand.
但是他知道我是在试炼当中。But
he knows that he is going through a trial.
但是他讲出这句话很宝贵。Is
when he spoke this is very critical.
他知道啊，他试炼我，我出来的时候就必如金晶。
He knows that when he had tested me, I shall come forth as gold.
我们知道金晶是怎么来打出来的。We
know the process of refining gold.
金晶就是纯金啊，在自然界是不存在，自然界是那些有杂质的金子跟石头跟矿物混在一起。So
you know that pure gold is without impurities, that's mixed with other kind of stones.
然后呢，你要烧它、提炼它，有很高的温度。
And you must use high temperature to heat it up.
还有呢, 要烧完之后要去打,
and after it's burned, you must hammer it.
打到很薄,
you must mold it to be very thin.
达到你要的这个设计,
and you will mold it to the shape that you desire.
金子有一个很特大的特性啊,
the gold has a very unique property.
第一,它是可以提炼的,可以把杂质拿走。
First, it is that it can get rid of all the impurities.
还有越纯的金呢,它要越软。
And also, the more pure the gold it is, the more soft it is.
这个人不知道啊，就是完全99.999%全金啊，很软的，你有牙齿咬了可以凹下去。
So you can see that 99.99% gold is, if it's very soft, you can even bite it with using your teeth.
因为啊，金子薄薄的打得很软，可以塑造不同的形状。
And because when gold is hammered to a very thin layer, it is malleable to become any kind of shape.
就好像我们一开始所说的。
Just like what we said in the beginning.
这是进入我们的第二点。
And this is to our second point.
所以我们受苦就是要造就我们。
Jesus Christ, when we go through trials, it is for our own sake.
第一点我们讲的是荣耀神嘛。第二点呢，我们讲到说就是来造就我们，改变我们。
And first we talked about when we go through suffering, we bring glory to God. Secondly, we talked about when we go through suffering, we edify ourselves.
我们看诗篇119篇67节。
Psalms chapter 119 verse 67.
诗篇119篇67节
Psalms chapter 119 verses 67. 67 Before I was afflicted I went astray but now I keep your word.
这里说没有受苦之前呢，我走迷路了。
Before trials I went astray.
我们昨天晚上讲过了，人的心其实很硬的。Last
time we talked about man's heart is very hard.
硬心就是不会听人家讲。When
your heart is hard you will not listen to other people.
你已经决定做一件事情，你就会叫做到底。
That when you decide to do something, you will go forth with it no matter what.
别人讲你,劝你,你会觉得很烦。
And people trying to encourage you may think you and you find them annoying.
因为你已经觉得我要做了。
Because you already haven't made a decision that you're going to do it.
就像浪子, 圣经里面浪子的比喻。
Just like the parable of the lost sons.
他离开家里,
he left the home.
丧尽父亲的财产。
And he wasted all the inheritance given by his father.
那个时候还没有想要回家。
At that time, he didn't think about going home.
什么时候想回家呢?
When did he think about going home?
钱花光呢?
When he has wasted all his money.
当地遇到大饥荒.
And at that land, it experienced famine.
他帮人家喂猪.
And he was feeding, helping other people feeding the swine.
他想吃那个猪吃的, 人家都不给他.
And he wants to eat the food that was given to the swine, yet it was not given to him.
比猪都不如.
And you can see that in comparison to the pig, he is not even worth a pig.
很快他就会被饿死.
And naturally, he will starve to death.
为什么?
How come?
你自己选呢,你自己?
You made your own choice.
但是他这个时候想回家了。
But at that time, he wants to return home.
钱花光了,肚子饿了,想回家了。
He wasted all his money, and he is hungry, and he wants to return home.
大家才会说,哎呀,我以前做错了,得罪了神了,又得罪了你。
Then he realized that, oh, I have committed a great error, I have sinned against God, I have sinned against you.
所以你说受苦好不好?
So is suffering good?
诗人就说了,受苦很好。
And the poet have said it is good that one go through suffering.
我以前走迷了路.
And previously have gone astray.
走迷就是不是走在神的道路上面.
To go astray, it is no longer walking a pathway to God.
你走在你自己想走的道路.
Going astray is walking a pathway of your own choice.
神是很开明的, 你想走你就走.
God is very accepting. If you want to choose a pathway to go, you may.
神不会阻止你走.
God will not block your path.
但是如果神对你还有点希望, 没有放弃你,
but God has still have hope in you and has not given up on you.
神会很快就让你受苦,
and God will make you go through sufferings.
如果神没有让你受苦,
if God did not allow you to go through sufferings,
对不起, 神就不要你了已经,
and perhaps God does not want you to come.
所以有时候你会说, 哎呀, 怎么我那么倒霉, 一个安息日不来了, 又车祸又拉肚子又怎么样?
How come you say to yourself, oh, I'm so unfortunate that just because I missed one Sabbath day, I got to call it, I actually have stomach.
三年没来的,
and the other person, for 3 years have not come, he has to church, he's living very well. And
哇,
he earned a lot of money.
为什么我那么倒霉?
How come I'm very unfortunate?
一点点神不高兴就来管教我?
Just for a very small error that God come and discipline me.
你不是倒霉, 你是神爱你。
It's not because you are unfortunate, it's because God loves you.
神不希望你走太远。
God does not want you to go astray.
因为你会心蒙脂油啊,第七十节说啊,心蒙脂油啊。
And in verse 70 says, because their hearts are as fat as grease.
骄傲的人啊,第六十九节啊, 说谎啊，然后心蒙自由。
And these are examples of the person who are proud. They are lied and their heart is fat grease.
这个心被油包住啊，根本就感觉不到啊，神的话、神的爱、神的警告啊。
So when the heart is fat and greased, they are unable to experience the word of God or warnings from God.
神说没有用了，讲没有用了，一棍子打下来。
And God said, "Oh, it's very useless with words. Therefore, I will use a physical punishment."
最有效的管教就是棍子。
The most effective discipline it is striking with a rod.
教小孩子都是这样啊。
You can discipline your children in that way.
12岁以前讲不听，不用多讲了，棍子一教就懂了。
Before the age of 12, if they do not listen to you, you discipline them with a rod.
对呀，他受苦他才会听啊。
Only when they go through suffering, they will listen.
幼稚的人就是要吃苦才会听。
Those people who are immature only go through suffering, then they will listen.
聪明的、有智慧的，讲一讲，马上就听。
And those people who are with wisdom, if you tell them certain things, they will listen immediately.
那你要当哪一种？你要当那个讲一讲就听的，还是被打了半死才听的？
What kind of people would you want to be? Do you want to be the person that if you say a few words, you will listen, or you must be punished to listen?
所以啊，神在管教我们的时候，试炼的时候。
So when God is disciplining us when we go through trials.
哇，要感谢主啊，要开心大喜乐。
So we must thank God that we must count in all joy.
我们看希伯来十二章。
Let's turn back to Hebrews chapter 2.
第七节。12章的七节
Chapter 12, verse 7. If you endure chastening, God deals with you as with his sons, and with son is there whom a father does not chasten?
第八节
Verse 8. But if you are without chastening, of which all have become partakers, then you are illegitimate and not sons.
这里说两种儿子
Here, talk about two sons.
一种就是狮子，不是 lion 啊，狮身子 illegitimate son.
Here it says about illegitimate son.
就是跟这个是外面生的，不是自己承受产业的。
It is the son you have outside. So it's not the son who inherit everything from you.
那种儿子的不会被爸爸管。
And that type of son will not be chastened by the father.
但是那个真正是自己的儿子，那爸爸会管。
But if it's his own true son, then he will chasten.
因为啊，这个以后要给他承受产业的。
Because in the future he will receive your inheritance.
要骂，要训练，要责备，要更正。
So he must correct, discipline, and rebuke.
所以神也是这样对我们啊。
So God is also treating us in this way.
所以我们今天如果遇到试炼是因为自己的软弱的话
，then today if you're going through various trials because of our weaknesses,
我们呢也要大大的喜乐，大大的感谢。
And we should have great joy and give thanks always.
好，那我们来讲第三点。
Now, so our third point.
啊，受苦呢是为了让我们可以安慰别人。帮助别人。
When we go through suffering, it's for the sake that we can edify others and help others.
我们看希伯来书二章的十八节。
Let's read Hebrews chapter 2, verse 18.
希伯来书二章的十八节。
Hebrews chapter 2, verse 18. For in that he himself has suffered being tempted, he is able to aid those who are tempted.
这里说主耶稣为什么可以帮我们，可以搭救我们
？Here it talks about why Jesus Christ are able to help us.
因为他自己被试探过，也受过苦。
Because he himself has suffered and been tempted.
受过苦了，让主耶稣真正可以理解，可以帮助我们。
When Jesus Christ suffered, therefore he can truly understand with what we're going through.
我们看哥林多后书第一章。
Let's turn Second Corinthians chapter 1.
哥林多后书的第一章。
Second Corinthians chapter 1.
第三节。
Verse 3. Blessed be God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort.
这里说神呢是发慈悲的父，是各样安慰的神。
Because the Father is the mercies and God of all comforts.
当然，爸爸要严厉，要管教是没有错。
So naturally, it's very correct for a father to show sternness and discipline.
主内做爸爸的也不能开口闭口就是骂人了，也不对。
So as a father in the Lord, you cannot always rebuke.
做一个爸爸，我们要向天父学习。
So as a father, you must learn from the Father above.
你同时间要管教，但是同时间也要怎么安慰你的儿女。
At the same time, when you are disciplining, you must also comfort them.
今天很多亚洲的爸爸就是只会骂的，只会管，但是呢，对孩子没有 show affection， 没有让孩子感觉到你的爱。
As an Asian father, you may always resort to stern rebukes and not enough affections.
所以有一些孩子长大了，跟爸爸关系很疏远。
So therefore, many people when they grow up, they have a distant relationship with their own father.
其实啊。圣经来说，天父是慈悲的。我们应该做爸爸的，要学习天父的那种心。
Here the Bible says, the Father of mercies, we must learn from him.
孩子应该可以从爸爸当中得到安慰。
So Children should receive comfort from their father.
那怎么样安慰呢?
Then how should we comfort?
第四节,
Verse 4. Who comforts us in all tribulation, that we may be able to comfort those who are in any trouble with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God.
这里说啊,
And Paul, and he, when he was suffering with other co-workers, he encouraged the church of Corinth.
为什么主耶稣可以安慰他们?
How come Jesus Christ was able to comfort them?
因为主耶稣自己受过苦嘛?
Because Jesus Christ has gone through suffering.
好了，那保罗他们自己受苦了。
And Paul, he gone through suffering as well.
他们从神那边得到安慰。
That he has received comfort from God.
结果呢，他们又转过去安慰那遭各样患难的人。
And therefore, he encouraged all, and he in turn he encouraged all those who are going through tribulations.
你想看保罗，如果他们没受苦啊，有没有办法去安慰别人？
Can you imagine if Paul has never gone through any tribulation, were he able to comfort other people?
没办法.
It's impossible.
他只会高高站在讲台上面教训人，他没有办法去安慰人.
He may preach on Napoleon, but he will not be able to comfort anyone.
哎，他们受苦了.
And they have gone through suffering.
从基督里面得安慰.
They were able to receive comfort in the Lord.
好，转身来，他要去安慰那些同样受同样苦难的人。And
in turn, they are able to encourage all those who are going suffering what they have gone through.
原来教会啊，就是一个最多安慰的团体。So
you see that church itself is a body of people who are able to comfort each other.
这里有神的安慰。Here
has a comfort of God.
有人的安慰。And
also the comfort of men.
所以啊，第五节。
And so verse 5.
我们既多受基督的苦楚，就靠基督多得安慰。
For as the suffering of Christ abound in us.
这句话可能要用生命去体会。
You may have to experience this verse throughout your life.
你苦难越多，在别人眼中你很可怜。
The more suffering you have, it may seem that from others' perspective, you're very sad.
但是在保罗眼中，我们多受苦难，我们就多得安慰。
But in Paul's eye, when we receive many trials, we will be able to comfort others.
那保罗在监牢当中啊，神都与他同在。
That even though Paul was going in prison, God was still abiding with him.
在孤单的时候，别人都安慰不了他，神亲自安慰他。In
times of loneliness, no one able to encourage him, but God Himself encouraged Paul.
他说：“主耶稣站在我旁边，加给我力量。”
Jesus Christ is with me, strengthening me.
这种安慰是很大的。And
this comfort is very great.
这种没有办法体会，没有经历过，没有办法体会。And
those who have not gone through, we are unable to experience it.
所以多受，多为基督受苦难，就多靠基督得安慰。
And if when you suffer more for Christ, you will be comforted more.
第六节啊,
Verse 6.
我们受患难是为叫你们得安慰得拯救，我们也得安慰那样。Now,
if you are afflicted, it's for your consolation and salvation, which
所以我们最近啊，其实每一个人、每一个家庭都有一些困难。So
in recent times, many of our family are going through some kind of trials.
有人是生病。And
some have become sick.
有人家庭问题。
And some have family issues.
有人失业,
some have lost their job.
有人可能有精神的困扰,
and some are suffering from mental strains.
我们都需要安慰,
we all need some kind of comfort.
所以我们这个时候要互相的安慰,
and now we must comfort each other.
好，那如果你今天在受这个病,
and today, if you are going through some type of suffering,
你可能要想为什么我要得这个病。
And if you have some kind of illness, you must think, well, why am I going through this kind of illness?
或者是为什么我今天受这个苦?
And you say, oh, how come I'm going through this kind of suffering? And right now, you may not understand the meaning, the spiritual meanings behind it.
但是有一天你会知道,
but one day, you will understand.
你当你从这里走过了,出来的时候,
once you have gone through this trial and you have come out of it,
当你把这个经验跟别人分享的时候,
and when you finally share this experience with others,
哇, 别人可能会从你那边得到很大的安慰。
That from you, others may be greatly edified.
他说，我不知道你也经历过这个事情。They
will say, I did not know that you were going through such a thing.
你笑笑地跟他说，其实我也经历过。And
you were smiling, said to them, I also experienced it.
只是我当初没有跟别人讲。But
at that time, I did not tell anyone.
那今天神让我跟你讲，我经历过了。And
today, God wants me to tell you what I experienced.
我可以走出来。I
have come out of it.
你也可以靠主走出来。You
can also come out of it with the reliance of the Lord.
这个就是很大的安慰啊。And
this is a great comfort.
这个就是苦难也可以让我们让别人得到造就。And
so this is how suffering may bring edification for others.
有一位姐妹也是这样子。There
was once a sister who experienced the same thing.
她得到忧郁症。
She had received a great she received depression.
哇, 别人跟她讲, 要有信心, 要喜乐, 要怎么样怎么样?
Other people have told her to have faith, to have joy, and etc. etc.
她觉得你们这些健康的人,
and then the sister said, those all of you who are healthy are unable to experience what I'm going through.
我也知道喜乐啊, 但是我忧郁症,
I know that I need to be joy, but since I'm depressed, I'm unable to feel joy.
她觉得别人讲的话都很空洞。
So she feels that the words that others spoken are full of emptiness. But until one day, there was a sister who knows that she was diagnosed with depression.
那去看,
and this sister went to visit her.
她说,
and this sister said, I understand you.
因为十多年前也发生过一样的事。
She said, oh, 10 plus years ago, I also gone through similar experience.
那时候我刚退休,突然间不晓得怎么样,我就得了忧郁症。
And at that time, I retired. And unknowingly, I don't know why I have received, I was diagnosed with depression.
她讲这样的时候,那个姐妹听了就眼睛就大了。诶,我看你那么好,你怎么会得这种病?
At that time, the sisters who was diagnosed with depression, widened her eyes and said, oh, I see that you are very healthy. How come you are diagnosed with depression?
她回答说,其实每一个人都有机会得这种病。
And the older sister said, everyone has a chance to be diagnosed with depression.
不是你信心不好,你就才会得这种病。
It's not because your faith is not good, therefore you have this kind of illness. Everyone has a chance to be diagnosed with depression.
那姐妹就问她,
then this younger sister said, oh, how did you come out of it?
哇,
and this older sister shared with her.
其实分享的内容都一样, 也是靠神啊, 祷告啊,
and the content of it is the same. You must rely on God and pray, but it is different because it is spoken from a person who has gone through it. Because this sister's life was comforted by God. So she is able to comfort those who are going through suffering. So you can see the wonderful will of when we are suffering. It can help us to glorify God. It can adjust any misbehavior we may have.
也可以帮助我们去安慰别人。
It can also help us to edify others.
所以各位在试炼当中，雅各长老告诉我们。
So Elder James tells us.
落在百般的试炼中。
And when you fall into very all tribulations.
我们都要以为大喜了。
We'll have count with a great joy.
因为你们知道信心经过试验。
Because you know that when you go through tests of your faith.
就生忍耐。
Produces patience.
但是忍耐也要成功哦, 要忍到底哦。
And to be patient, you must persist till the end.
雅各书第一章第四节很重要。
And James chapter 1 verse 4 is very important.
忍耐也当成功。
That patience has its perfect work.
你不要说我忍了一半了，我不忍了。
That you cannot say to yourself, I only endure halfway.
我信了一半，我不信了。
I will believe halfway, and I will no longer.
你信一半不信，你就没有用了。
If you believe halfway, then it is worthless.
忍那么久了，你都忍下去。
That since you are enduring, then you must endure to the end.
主耶稣不会让我们承担不住啊。
Jesus Christ will not give up on us.
所以要我们成全完备，毫无缺欠。
Jesus Christ wants us completely to obey Him, to believe in Him.
唱诗359首。
Sing 359.